Betilde Muñoz Bogosian. I'm originally from Venezuela. I have actually really built my career on issues of democratic governance, elections, election observation. I am now director of social inclusion in the Secretariat for Access to Rights and Equity at the OAS, where I am in charge of leading the agenda on the inclusion of vulnerable populations for the region, the equity promotion and economic and social rights agenda, as well as one of the most demanding areas of work for the region, which is migration and forced displacement. And I also led all the projects that allow the standardization of election observation for the OAS. I am very happy to see that they continue using all those manuals, all those tools, all the questionnaires that I helped standardize in that that time that I was in the democracy building team at the OAS. So that would definitely be something like a legacy, really, that I've left in that work that the OAS does for the whole of the region. In this role as Director of Social Inclusion, I think one of the greatest impacts that I am fortunate to have been able to have is on the issue of Venezuelan migration. As you know, over 5 million Venezuelans have left the country in the last, 4 or 5 years, 80% of them settling in Latin American countries because of a persistent, complex humanitarian crisis. And in the role that I have, and considering that I have the responsibility to implement the migration and forced displacement agenda at the OAS, I am also very fortunate to help my fellow Venezuelans all around the region and all around the world in finding opportunities, in doing advocacy so that the receiving countries can develop policies that can benefit their integration in these new societies. It gave me the privilege to connect to the, you know, Venezuelan migration crisis and refugee crisis and help my country in a way, not directly, but in a way. The Organization of American States, also known as the OAS, is an international intergovernmental organization composed by 34 member states, all within the Western Hemisphere. The agenda that I lead at the OAS is pretty straightforward in the sense of the promotion and respect of human rights and generating, you know, reducing poverty and eliminating, hopefully eliminating, but at least reducing inequality. And I think that's really why so many people connect to the work we're doing in social inclusion. But perhaps something that people don't understand is the value of political dialogue and the value of cooperation between countries. And with so many health issues that people from Venezuela face as they transition to the countries that they plan to settle, how important it is to make sure that Colombia, Ecuador, and Peru are talking to each other, and we at the OAS are facilitating that conversation so that they do not vaccinate them in Colombia and then vaccinate them again in Peru or vaccinate them again in Ecuador, but that there's coordination and there's mechanisms in place so that the information can be shared. We are all the result of our life histories, right? And different opportunities or lack of opportunities that we've had. I personally have always felt the vocation to serve greater causes rather than myself. I'm Venezuelan by birth, but have become I'm a U.S. citizen by naturalization, right? And this experience of being a migrant in a new country also opened the world for me. In this field of political science, I also, along with three other colleagues, we established 6 years ago, the only one in its genre, a network of female political scientists writing about Latin America, from Latin America. The Red de Politólogas No Sin Mujeres is in Spanish. In English, it would be the Network of Female Political Scientists, hashtag Not Without Women. It is really a network of over 650 female political scientists from Latin America who have generally been made invisible by what we call a gendered field of political science. So it all started as a way to put together a roster. We've also become somehow for big media channels like CNN, NTN 24 for the region, Bloomberg News. We've become their go-to place to find women to show in radio interviews, TV interviews. We actually feel great because we're accomplishing this goal of putting light and giving a voice to so many women who have so much to contribute. They just haven't had the chance.